the overlords of the New World Order, are now aggressively pushing for a worldwide one-child policy. The Chinese one-child policy was phased in gradually. In the 60s, when it began, you only had to pay a tax penalty. Only later did they imprison you if you had more than one child. Now the exact same proposals to penalize couples who have more than one child are being made in the United States, England, and Europe.
In the push to reduce global warming, children, according to some, are the new culprits. A think tank in the UK says too many kids are what's making the planet worse, saying large families, anything over two children really, should be frowned upon as an environmental no-no, akin to not reusing your plastic bags, driving one of those big gas-guzzling cars, taking long trips overseas. The UK, in fact, has negative growth. I think Canada does too. That still, families in our rich countries shouldn't have more than two kids.
The eugenics movement has now shaken off much of its Nazi baggage and is using people's legitimate concern about the environment as a cloak to conceal their real agenda. Everyone wants to breathe clean air and have good water, but the controllers of the environmental movement have done nothing but co-opt people's concerns and parlay it into support for global policies that further destabilize the third world and create untold misery. Phony environmental and conservation groups are now the biggest private landowners in the world. They lobby government to take property away from local populations, only to develop it themselves later. When the U.S. military dumps millions of gallons of nerve gas on the east coast of the U.S., they don't say a word. The corporate elite of the planet intensified their push for a global taxation system with a year-long buildup to the Live Earth hysteria held on July 7, 2007 on seven continents. World leaders announced that saving the Earth was the new organizing principle for humanity and hailed it as the planet's new religion. They claim that CO2, which plants breathe, was killing the Earth and that we must reduce the number of children we have to curtail our carbon footprint. Countries across the world marked the day by passing new carbon tax schemes and raising taxes on gasoline, natural gas, and electricity. It is a scientific fact that the sun is the main driver of planetary climate, and the measurements are clear. The sun is becoming hotter, brighter. It has been slowly increasing thermal output in the last 100 years, causing warming not just on Earth, but throughout the solar system. But the scientific facts and even the order of the planets didn't matter to one of the chief organizers of Live Earth, David Mayer de Rothschild, heir to the British arm of the Rothschild fortune, when we spoke to him. When I called Rothschild on the order of the planets, he just laughed, thinking the audience wouldn't get it. He continued to count on the population's ignorance and claimed that the global warming lobby has nothing to do with carbon taxes. I guess he hadn't spoken with his good personal friend, Al Gore.
Global warming, the time for debate is over. I think what you have to realize is that being environmentally sensitive and making money aren't mutually exclusive. There's a lot of money to be made in addressing this issue.
But you guys are gobbling up all the world's concern to just simply line your pockets and make kids read your book in schools and do all this. It's a business, just like you said, Rothschild.
It's not. Do you think I make any money out of this?
It's the same thing. It's the same thing your great-great-great-grand, your money-changing ancestors did. They're in Germany, Red Shield, and I'm calling you out, Red Shield. We know it's a scam.
A pollution-based tax system, principally CO2. We're causing it mainly, vast majority of it. The consequences are bad and will be catastrophic unless we act.
The polar ice caps of Mars are receding at several miles a year, much faster than ours, and that the moons of Saturn and Jupiter are melting. In fact, several of their moons were ice and are now liquid seas. Now, how are SUVs causing that, David Rothschild?
That's because those planets are closer to the sun, my friend.
No, Jupiter and Saturn are not closer to the sun. Neither is Mars.
Yes, sir. I think you'll find, right, that the very simple matter, and what I wanted to say, and this is my final point, forget your taxation theory, because actually it's not taxation.
Put a price on the carbon. A tax is the best way. Cap and trade can also do it.
If there were a carbon-based tax, would there be a need for an economy-wide cap and trade system?
They are not either or. We can do both. I am in favor of both.
Now we will reveal what Barack Obama and his controller's true agenda is. Number one, bring the United States under the complete regulatory control of a private offshore superbank known as the Bank of the World. More than 100 new taxes are now being developed under the umbrella of curbing greenhouse gases. The new taxes will be paid directly to the private bank consortium. At the producer level, taxes will be paid on farm animals' flatulence. At the consumer level, there will be carbon taxes on all forms of meat, beef, poultry, pork, and fish. All cars will be fitted with satellite tracking boxes that will tax driving by the mile. And an added tax will be placed on all fossil fuels, including motor oil and natural gas. All plastic products will have a carbon tax added. Outdoor space heaters and fireplaces are to be taxed. All electricity produced by coal-powered plants will be taxed. Under the cap-and-trade system, citizens will be forced to pay taxes on thousands of products to private cap-and-trade services owned by Al Gore and other elitists. There will be taxes on light bulbs, water, trash pickup, air travel, train travel, bus, ship, medicine, steel production, mining, clothing, laundry, asphalt are just a few of the new taxes to be levied.
But to truly transform our economy, to protect our security and save our planet from the ravages of climate change, we need to ultimately make clean, renewable energy the profitable kind of energy. So I ask this Congress to send me legislation that places a market-based cap on carbon pollution and drives the production of more renewable energy in America. That's what we need.
The notion of anthropogenic global warming is a fraud. In other words, the idea that the planet is getting warmer and that human activity is somehow responsible is a pseudoscientific fraud. It's a big lie. It's a monstrosity. Remember the Nazis, they had race science, race hygiene. They said Aryan blood is different from any other kind of blood. This was, of course, idiocy, a fantastic piece of nonsense. Today, we've got something similar. Global warming caused by human activity, and the answer to that is carbon tax plus cap and trade, according to the wishes of Al Gore, Prince Charles, and basically the entire world banking community, the world oligarchy. What they're trying to do with that is to perpetuate the current system where bankers rule the world, financiers rule the world, and the rest of us get the crumbs from the table.
Let's go to Jim in West Virginia. Jim, you're online.
Oh, yeah. Jason, you've heard about people getting fined thousands of dollars a day and run out of their home, correct?
Yes.
Yes, it's happened thousands of times just in Texas and New York. Would you like to know the name of the code they use to do this?
Let's hear it.
Okay, on paper, it's a $21 trillion scam. It's the International Property Theft Code, and it's labeled the International Property Maintenance Code. Mm-hmm. Worse than NAIS, Ecology Easements, and Eminent Domain combined.
Now, let me just stop you here. Now, this looks like something that they're going to do through this latest climate bill that they put into place. They're going to say that now they need to go into your home and make sure it's energy efficient, and if you can't home energy efficient, they're going to start fining you, and then if you can't pay those fines, they're going to just take your home. And they're already doing this?
Jason, it's been in plain sight since 2000. You can exquick it, okay? Now, it isn't a legitimate law passed by a legislature and signed into law. It's a code that a jurisdiction can just adopt and enforces it as if it's legitimate. Do you want a two-minute synopsis of it?
Yes, please.
Okay, the code official is the sole interpreter. Forget due process. Mm-hmm. Every day that a violation occurs is a mandatory misdemeanor, jailable and finable. Anything the code official says is not in good working order, $555 a day and or a month in jail in Charleston, West Virginia. Numbers vary with jurisdiction. Do you want examples of not in good working order?
Yes.
Sticky window, loose window, dented gutter, plugged gutter. Anything he says is an unsanitary condition. Examples, puddles, dog droppings, empty cans on your property. Same deal, $555 and or a month in jail in Charleston, West Virginia, slithering across the nation.
And what other, do you know any other counties or regions that are, have
I'll tell you how
adopted
to find
this?
Okay.
What's that?
You go to www.iccsafe.org. Repeat, www.iccsafe.org. Look mm-hmm. for adoptions. Click it, and you'll see where we know that it exists.
But it is the awareness itself that will drive the change. And one of the ways it will drive the change is through global governance and global agreements.
Do you understand how dark it is? How far down the line we are? How late it is?